gone too long. Prayed for a few weeks. If you'll just agree with me. Father, I just want to thank you that you came to give. And you gave your best. You gave your son, Jesus. Now I thank you for him. And that you've been born again and he lives in our hearts. And
yes.
Lord, we want to lift up Paul Howell to you, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
And we want to ask you to touch him and heal him, Lord.
Yes, Lord.
Father, we want to ask you to minister to his pain, Lord, and that you would meet him, Lord, God, and heal him. God, we want to ask you, in our weaknesses and the frailties of our body, we don't tell you what to do. We ask you to meet us in our points of brokenness and weakness and pain and suffering and confusion, whatever it is. And we ask you, God, that you would bless our brother, that you would meet him. We love him, and we appreciate him, and we ask you to meet him where he is today and heal him, Lord God, by your Spirit. Using physicians, whatever way you want, God, that you would touch him and minister to him. Father, there are other sisters and brothers in this congregation that are receiving your healing touch. Lord God, and I just pray that you would continue to meet them. You know each heart here, and God, you've heard each heart, and you know each need. And Father, we ask you to meet us. And Father, we thank you that your Spirit dwells within us, and greater is he that's in us than he that's in the world. And Father, we ask that as we go anywhere, that he would rise up in us, and we would proclaim the good news wherever we are, whether it be in a gym, the grocery store, in our homes, amongst family, amongst those that don't know you. Father, you're so wise, and your ways are above ours. You can use us in ways we can't even think of.
Yes.
So God, we lay down our ideas of how you do things.
Yes,
we lay down who we are, and we ask you to fill us to overflowing, God. You said that you would place us in situations and places where we weren't prepared for, but don't worry about it. I'll give you the words, and I'll tell you what to do. So Father, we just thank you wherever we are, whether we're amongst our family, we're amongst the world, we're in a hospital, we're amongst the elderly, wherever we are, God, that we're yours and you can use us any way you want. So fill us to overflowing, meeting our needs, but so that we're so full of you, we just overflow to the world around us. God, and they become refreshed because of who you are in us. We're your feet, and God, bring us where you want us. And let us lay our hands, whether it be just to touch someone, handshake. It doesn't have to be all oiled up and all that. God, it can be simply by living the life and unto you. So bless us, Lord, and touch us in all of our needs. Each one, you know each one today. Meet those needs in Jesus' name.
Amen.
You know, I want to tell you, I go to Curbs. It's a real holy place, right? It's an exercise place. And I don't go in there going, I'm a pastor's wife. As a matter of fact, I like that not to be known. Not that I'm ashamed, but people get all acting like they think you want to hear and do. So this way I can just be with people, and you should hear the needs in there, the women as they talk. And then one found out, one of my titles. And she, right there in Curves, we prayed. Right there. Right there. So it doesn't all happen in here. In here is where we're amongst each other who believe. And we build ourselves up and we don't neglect meeting. More so now than ever. So we can get built up and we love each other. Then we go out there so we don't fall apart and rush off with everyone else. Because everybody out there is hurting in these needs. The only difference between us who know him is that very thing. We know him.
Right.
Or we may be a little further in our journey. We may have a little more faith at that moment. But it could change where we need someone else's strength. To hold our arms up. God is the great equalizer to keep us all humble. You don't have to humble each other.
No.
He's quiet anyway. So be filled to overflowing.
Amen.
Hallelujah.